saying, rejoice,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
The Virgin Mary. And then all around the borders are
images of saints. Of course, they're, like I said, well, all of those churches have basically the same format, but different churches will have different saints,
perhaps were locally venerated.
The saints depicted on the borders are the saints of some of the first monks that lived here. During church, or they do prostrations, or there's more penitential prayers. And on the wall, you see icons that, again, were wanted to have them in a different veneration. You'll see relics of the saints, which are venerated, as we believe that Christians are transformed by faith. Grace of God, and if they're on favor with God, their bodies also
sanctified.
Because we believe that the body and soul united until death, but the bodies, the remains of the saint, continue to bear the grace of God until the future resurrection. So we have relics of saints from the early church, from some of the apostles here, we have a piece of the cross here. So the piece I'm showing you in a minute, the belt of the Mother of God that she wore. Some of these were given to us, well, most of them were given to us by people that during the communist times got them out of Russia. Because I guess so much was destroyed in Russia. Some things actually were kept in museums in Russia because, well, God works in strange ways. People, the communists, you know, they thought, well, you know, this belongs in a museum. And so, and recently, many of them also returned to the church. Like, there was a piece of Christ's robe was kept in Jerusalem in the 7th century, stolen by the Parthians, or the Persians. And in the 17th century, a Shah of Iran gave it to the Grand Duke of Moscow, the Emperor, the Tsar of Moscow, as a gift. And so, they built actually a church in the Kremlin to keep it. And then that church was blown up. And the first thing the communists did was to blow that church up after they took over. But the relic was kept in the museum. And then a few years ago, the president of Russia returned it to the church, and it's kept in Christ's Sacred Cathedral for veneration, a piece of the robe of Jesus Christ. Which separates the sanctuary from the main body of the church. So it's similar, we'd say, to like the Holy of Holies was in the temple in Jerusalem. Into that area, only people that are consecrated to God can enter, like priests, deacons, servers, they go in to help with the service. And you can see in Western, old Western churches,
like a low, because Akin walls are originally very low. But as time went on, people became less pious, the wall grew up to keep the sanctity of the church. The gates in the middle are called the royal gates because during the liturgy, the bread and wine are carried in procession out of the altar and back in the royal gates of the kingdom court. That's why the, and the curtain is drawn and shut during different parts of the service. There's always an icon of Christ on the right and the left an icon of the right. And quite often the Russian church is now worshiping the icon of St. Nicholas and the local saint of the church. Then on the upper row you have feast days of the church. And then here we have a third row, which is the Old Testament saints and New Testament. And in Russia, sometimes we admit to five rows in some larger churches. This is all done here in Monastery.
Padre, ¿puedes explicar eso en español de la portada para que? ¿Puedes explicar eso de, en español sobre la portada y la entrada? Dice que la portada, en español la portada, es como la portada que había en el templo en Jerusalén, en donde ya le llevan el vino y el pan ahí al altar, pero está fuera de la vista, solo abierta durante ya el época de la Pascua, está abierta para que los penitentes vean, pero ya está cerrado, porque es el santo de los santos ya.
During the Pascua, during the first week, Pascha, as we call it, Easter, the gates are kept open all the time to show that paradise is now reopened to mankind.
Which service is it? What language is it?
Both Slavonic, which is like old, it's not just old Russian, it's like Latin, and Hebrew, Italian, and Spanish.
Yeah.
It's a little bit different, though, because when Christianity started to hold it, what the people spoke was their name. They speak Hebrew. Hebrew was the language of the temple. But they're very similar, of course. And then people started going out, the apostles started going out to different countries. And so Greek was, from the very time, was the very important language of the church. Because it was the language of culture. And even in Western Europe, Greek was the language of the church of old age. Up until the 4th or 5th century, they started using Latin. So Jerome translated the Gospels into Latin. It's called Vulgate, the Vulgate meaning the language of the people. And so when the Slavic tribes showed interest in Christianity, they didn't have a literary language. So they developed, St. Cyril and Philippus actually worked very much on this. They were familiar with the Slavic. Translated little by little, it started by them, what they called Slavonic, which was a church language in Slavic for the people. And that process went on a long time, and so as Christianity in Russia, they had a language they could understand. So now we are going through a process here where we're using more and more English because the younger people don't know Russian, so it's much. Those that come to Russia, of course, do, but in Russia, it's sort of a problem because of communism. Slavonic is quite different from modern Russia. So if people go to church all the time, then they get used to it. But there's some controversy. Some people want to have Russian, and they're like, oh, no, you can't have the language, or they'll swear. It's that type of thing. So, but here we have Slavonic, sorry, mostly, but a lot of English now, too. Because we get people here from other countries, but then again, English is sort of the national language, too.
So in other Orthodox churches, would they speak like in the Greek Orthodox?
They use Greek, right?
So this artwork is really kept changing the rooms. Now, the right arm of St. John the Baptist is kept in Serbia, the monastery. St. John the Baptist, you know, he was beheaded by Herod Antipas, and the Jews buried it in a garbage heap, and it was rediscovered three times over the next few centuries. And then it was kept, and then some pieces were taken and given out to churches. And these relics are here. From all different saints. We're very blessed to have many, many relics. Only a part of them here. We have a whole chapel full of relics, and they're brought to church here on the feast days. In the altar, we have the relic of the cross, which is brought out on feast days dedicated to the cross of Christ. Showing the sash of the Virgin Mary over here. I mentioned before, this is a very cool. Thank you. So this day, there's no work. In Russia, people are encouraged to spend the day just in family, their parks and stuff like that, recreation. And so I was there for I don't know how long in Moscow, and probably about 2 million people there. They brought, and their little piece is actually in Moscow, there's a church right there, a bigger piece, but they brought it all out there.
Para los que hablan español, aquí hay un hilo de la faja de la Virgen, porque durante la ascensión ella dejó la faja abajo mientras ella subía al cielo. Y la reliquia, la faja entera está en Monte Athos, en el monasterio de Grecia. Pero aquí tienen un hilo de la faja de la Virgen que se puede ver en el icono.
¿La faja original?
La faja original que ella dejó ahí cuando su cuerpo se levantó ahí al cielo. Dejó ya la faja ahí en la cama y ahí los cristianos ya la guardaban hasta el Monte Athos, pero han regalado un hilo de la faja.
There was a very bad plague killing a lot of people in Istanbul. And what's interesting, these people were Muslims. Many of their ancestors had been Christians, and so that they kept a pious belief, many of them, that enjoy your prayers and whatever in the mosque, but if you really want to help, you somehow go to the Christian church. And so you'll find even today, like Palestine, they renovate some churches. There's some relics in Yafa, and in Israel, and St. Nicholas, the chains of St. Nicholas. So this plague was killing a lot of people. So the Sultan had, and Mount Athos at that time, northern Greece, was still under the Turks in the early 1900s. They asked the monks to let them take
el hilo original de la faja de la Virgen. Cuando la Asunción,
exactly, is the thread.
Right, yeah. It's in the. I see. Now, this is an icon with relics of modern day saints. Grand Duchess Elizabeth was a sister of the last Empress of Russia, and she was also married to a Grand Duke.
Sarah.
And her. She, after her husband was murdered, she started a convent in Moscow to help the poor, to educate young girls, to have a way to make a living. And when the communists took over, since she was a Romanov, you know, by marriage, they eventually arrested her, and she was killed along with other Romanov princes. It's shown here, this mine shaft. They were thrown down a mine shaft with a bomb after them. And her body was found on the floor by a white woman. There was a symbol going on. And her body and the other bodies were taken to China. And there was now a parking lot. And they've had a special excursion to try to find it. Anyway, we have, well, actually, her body. That was the other one. Her sister was the grandmother of Prince Philip, Prince Victoria. So when she found out about what happened to her sister, she had her body and Barbara's body brought from China to Israel. And so they're in the convent of Mount Athos, convent of the Seminary.
de la faja de la Virgen. Cuando ella asunció al cielo, el hijito me lo allí. El hilo original de la faja de la Virgen cuando subió a los cielos. Tócalo, mami. Vete, tócalo. My lovely wife touching. The original theme of the Virgin Mary after she went to the Ascension to the heaven.
¿Quiénes son? No son los apóstoles.
Mira, yo me estoy esperando.
Los 10 personajes que están ahí.
Los apóstoles.
Pero son 10.
Los apóstoles. Están esperando.
Pero por son 10. Pero es que nada más que hay 10. Pero por ahí tienen que estar los otros dos.
Ahí tiene que estar la Virgen.
Y no puse aquí abajo está la Virgen porque yo pensé primero que estaban.
Vamos, vamos.
¿Dónde están? Son 10 nada más, ¿eh?
Y abajo hay dos más.
¿En dónde? ¿En dónde estamos nosotros?
Yo pregúntale
cosas en el paño. ¿Dónde va por abajo?
En la capilla de
invierno. Vamos a purificarnos.
Chapo.